Hello, visit ProcessMaker.io, a highly scalable, highly resilient BPMN 2.0 workflow engine that is offered as a cloud microservice. It's very simple to begin using ProcessMaker I.O. Simply register on the site and create a cloud instance. The product is 100% API-based and has SDKs in all popular programming languages. Once your cloud instance is created, you can access the API and write applications against it. In this demo, we will show you a leave absence request process that was built using a third-party BPMN 2.0 editor and is being powered by ProcessMaker I.O. The most interesting part of this demo is that 100% of the front end is Slack. Essentially, this demo shows you how to power Slack with a workflow engine. In this example, the requester can make a time-off request using a Slack command, using the /// command in Slack. This creates a case in the workflow engine. The case gets routed to the approver. The approver is presented with wonderfully elegant and simple approve and reject buttons directly in the Slack interface. The requester waits for the decision from the approver. The requester waits for the decision from the approver about the time-off request. When the decision is made by the approver, then a Slack webhook will call a Slack action receiver. When this happens, an event will be passed to the approver. Then, based on the decision, the request will be routed as either approved or rejected. And finally, the requester will get the signal to finish properly. Requester and approver are separated by swim lanes in the BPMN 2.0 process diagram. Let's see this in action. First, I open my Slack and then I type the command, using the Slack /, in order to request a new leave of absence and specify the start and end dates of my requested time off. After entering this command, I'll get a private message which confirms my request with a case ID. Now I switch to the group where a managerial staff is supposed to review the leave of absence requests. This uses a first-come, first-serve queue, and any manager can pick up the request and process it. Here we see a bot message stating that an employee has requested time off on these start and end dates. There is a username and a case ID. Now I have the option to either approve or reject this request, using friendly buttons displayed in Slack. I decide to approve this request. After processing my input, the ProcessMaker I.O. workflow engine confirms my input and the option buttons are removed. Now, as the requester, I receive a private instant message regarding my request, including the dates and the decision from the manager. Also, there is a case ID for my records. Now let's make another request for different dates. Now I receive a confirmation and a new case ID. As a manager, I can visit a channel where I can see the request for the new dates, but this time I'll reject the request. The buttons disappear and I receive the confirmation message, stating that my decision has been recorded. As the requester, I receive an instant message stating that my second request was rejected. A case ID is also provided for reference. Looks awesome, right? To run this example, I created a PM Core instance under my account on the ProcessMaker.io website. There's a running instance, and you may refer to the form examples section for detailed instructions. In my Slack bot, I configure a slash command with the name absence request, and then enter the URI to my PM Core instance. I also configure where Slack interactive messages will send information to webhooks. I enter my PM Core domain here as well. Visit our ProcessMaker.io website to get your own process running. Stay tuned for more videos about other great use cases. And if you want to download the code for this Slack workflow engine, visit our ProcessMaker I.O. project on GitHub. Bye for now.